To go further in depth, we are joined by David Curry, president of Open Doors USA, an organization that issues an annual list of dangerous and difficult nations in which to practice Christianity. Moments ago, they just released their 2015 watch list. David, we are so appreciative of your time here this morning on America's Forum.
Well, thank you, JD, for having me on. I appreciate it.
David, first of all, tell us about the criteria you use to rate these nations.
Well, we're ranking persecution on a number of factors. There's governmental issues in many countries like North Korea. And then you have societal issues, religious conflict. We have family conflicts in some countries where religions and ideologies force families to attack or encourage families to attack people who convert to Christianity. There are about four or five factors that we consider, including violence, and how we rank these countries.
And of course, we are looking, for lack of a better term, David, we're looking at traditional nation states, but ISIS proclaims the rise of a new Islamic caliphate, and that organization has been almost morbidly public in its persecution of Christians. So is ISIS in a new category all its own?
Well, you see the ISIS, the Islamic State conflict, represented in the high ranking of Iraq and Syria, number 3 and number 4 on the World Watch List this year. And you're right, it cuts across some borders there, and they're trying to set up their own nation, their own caliphate. But you know what's interesting, JD, is that this is Islamic extremism represents 40 of the top 50 countries on the list. So it's not just the Islamic State, it's Boko Haram, it's all of these kinds of like agencies who have an ideology that they share in common, which makes the spread of Christianity, anybody reading a Bible, totally a very, very dangerous and difficult proposition.
Would you go so far as to say that this radical Islamic persecution is monolithic in nature, regardless of the different groups? You mentioned Boko Haram in Africa and, of course, ISIS in the Middle East.
I don't think monolithic is the right term, but I do think they're learning from each other. They're connected. Certainly, there are some funding sources that are the same. I think we all can understand that. But I think what you see right now in Nigeria, which is number 10 on the World Watch List, Boko Haram is learning from what is happening with the Islamic State. And they're, while they have been sort of scattershot, very dangerous, very brutal, more Christians died last year in Nigeria than some other countries on the list.
David, in the minute that remains in this segment, we note that North Korea topped your list for the past 12 years in a row. Why is that?
Because North Korea is, and it's as brutal, it's at the top for a reason. It's as brutal towards Christians as Iraq and Syria and the Islamic State. You have total governmental control. You have 50 to 70,000 Christians in labor camps. Not for any uncivil behavior as we would know it, but for reading a Bible, praying, converting to Christianity. There's a paranoia in that government that requires every citizen to worship the leader and for total obedience.
When we come back, we are going to go through the list, those nations where Christianity is outlawed, where the persecution remains rife. David Curry stays with us. You do too as we continue on this edition of America's Forum. Let's bring back in David Curry, the president of Open Doors USA, to talk more about this. David, we thank you for staying through the break. And let us get to the list itself. Of course, it has to be troubling year in and year out to catalog these nations. I believe we have a graphic, if my memory of cartography is correct. I think you call this a Mercator projection of the world, a flat map where we see the 2015 World Watch List and the nations depicted in a deep red pose perhaps the greatest danger. Let's begin in the Middle East. If you are to give us the nations that are most hostile toward Christianity, what would those be?
Well, it's very dangerous right now in Iraq and Syria. I know that people think of the Islamic State as a part of that scenario. What you have in Syria is a different maybe impetus for how that all got started with the failure of the government and the dictatorship there. But that is a very similar situation now on the ground. You have countries like Iran, which has gotten more dangerous for Christians, even though there's been a charm offensive from their new government that has not seen an improvement in the situation on the ground for Christians. They're not free to choose their own faith. They're not free to read a Bible. They're not free to sell a Bible or pick up a Bible. The very simple things that people here in the West come to understand as freedom of just even seeking religious freedom, that's not available there in Iran, Iraq, Syria, those countries.
Let's move now to the entire continent of Africa. As we look at those areas that continue to persecute Christians, what nations on that continent top the list?
Well, you have Somalia at number two, is a very dangerous country. You have a failed government. You have Islamic extremists there who attack Christians. Very dangerous. The kind of brutality that happens in Somalia is the same kind of brutality you've heard about in Iraq from the Islamic State, beheadings, people being attacked. Very dangerous to be a Christian there. You have a rise of violence, incredible violence in Nigeria, Sudan. It's continuing to grow. It's present all the time.
David, during the first part of our conversation, you mentioned that North Korea has topped the list for the last dozen years. Is North Korea still number one? And what else do we see in Asia and in that part of the world?
Well, North Korea is still number one. It's going to remain number one. The really scary fact is we don't even know how many Christians are being executed in North Korea. We have a lot of resources. We're connected with the network of folks there, but we just don't know. So there could be many, many more people being persecuted, executed in North Korea for their faith than we even know. There are episodes that you could see in Malaysia. All of a sudden, there's issues through the government, through the law, where people are trying to restrict the use of the name God in Malaysia and other countries throughout the Asian region. So it's still yet to be seen what's going to happen in some of these countries. They rank a little lower in Asia. China is, I think, still undecided as to what they feel about Christianity. But certainly Christians have a lot more freedom in China today than they did 30 years ago. But you still see issues there. Where the government is using their laws, their zoning laws, to restrict Christian expression, and that's troubling.
Final 30 seconds, a softer form of persecution, if you will, not obviously killing or torturing people, but a cultural bias turning against Christianity. Does that include most of the Western world?
One of the issues that we try to measure and we're looking at over time, it doesn't show up a lot on this list because the issues of violence are so strong, but we need to look in the future towards what I would call aggressive secularism and its impression on the expression of Christian faith in the West.
And we will remain mindful of that. Unfortunately, we'll have to leave it there. David Curry of Open Doors USA, we thank you for your time, and America's Forum continues right after this.